But moving on to topic number two, the Red Sox and the hot Red Sox. The Celtics are hot. I mean, the Bruins are hot. It's a hot time in the city right now to be a New England fan. I mean, hey, this is what we expect, right? City of champions, and Red Sox are kind of working their way towards the playoffs. It looks like already being a playoff contending team with the streak that they're on right now.
Yeah, you know, at the beginning of the season, the Red Sox started off 0-3, and everybody was, you know, thinking the sky was falling with this Red Sox team. You know, the pitching wasn't great. They weren't hitting right away. And, you know, that's the one thing you expected them to do. We knew that the rotation wasn't going to be great, especially to start without Chris Sale coming in. You know, you had Nick Pavetta coming in. You have Perez, who hasn't been a great starter for them. So you weren't sure, you know, if this team was ever going to pick it up. But after that original 0-3 start, you know, now the Red Sox have really picked it up. They've gone 12-3 since starting 0-3, and they're sitting in first place, even at least four games ahead of everybody else in the AL East. So we went from, you know, everybody's freaking out after going 0-3 to all of a sudden this team just can't be beaten. They're incredibly fun to watch because of the way they hit. So the lineup's hitting well. I still miss Mookie Betts. I wish they didn't trade him. But Alex Verdugo looks like a ball player, man. I'm very excited to continue to watch Alex Verdugo. He's been great. JD Martinez is having a bounce back year. We kind of figured that. We talked about that a couple of weeks ago, that he's probably going to be one of the best bounce back candidates for the Red Sox. That has proven to be the case so far. You know, Devers can still pick it up a little bit, but he's been hitting. Bogaerts is hitting as usual. And they've just been a lot of fun to watch. You know, they're 12-6. Awesome record in the month of April so far. And again, they're fun to watch. Last year, it was such a weird season, and they weren't hitting, and their pitching wasn't great, and you know, it just wasn't a fun Red Sox season. Never mind the fact that it was just a weird shortened season. This year, it's back to just loving throwing on the Sox at 7 o'clock every night and watching the Red Sox hit. And it's been a great season so far. You know, we don't want to be those fans that are like, we're in first place, and, you know, everything like that. And the Yankees are struggling because they are struggling, but it's so early, but you can't ignore the great start for the Red Sox so far.
I mean, I don't care if it was one game. I'm going to enjoy seeing the Yankees at the bottom of the series there, no matter what. And so it's really good to see them at the bottom and us at the top. But I mean, yeah, this is a team that started off slow. And I always say, and I think a lot of us from Boston know it too. I mean, this is a team, they kind of need the weather. So they go down to Florida, it's much warmer. They get into that kind of like feel of Florida weather. Then they come back to Boston and it's a little chilly here in the spring. The bats cool down a little bit. They're not like running around as fast. It's just a totally different feel, right? Once the weather starts coming around, turning around, the bats start getting hot again. And that's exactly what you're seeing with this team. They're really starting to adjust and adapt to being back in Boston, being with the spring weather here, and the weather's warming up. I mean, it was a beautiful 65-degree day today. Would have been played baseball, I think, and I think their game got postponed a little bit, though, because of a rainstorm that came in today. But it's starting to get better. Like I said, the weather's improving, and so is their play. And like I said, they started off slow in the preseason, but the more they play, they're just getting better, figuring out a great lineup to play. And yeah, Alex Verdugo, man, he is just amazing. And I think that's like a guy that is going to be a fan favorite for years to come, because he's just really starting to prove it, not only on the field with his play, but off the field with his interactions with the fans and the media. I think he's just turning into one of those guys where the city's really going to love him. I know I'm already starting to love him, seeing him rock that Cuban link chain and then going to rock a home run too. So this is a guy, a young superstar up and coming on the Red Sox, and the Red Sox are playing hot right now. So yeah, this is a team to watch right now. Keep your eyes out for the Sox going forward.
Yeah, I'm not sure if their rotation is going to be able to hold up throughout the season. That's, I think, their biggest question mark. I think we all know that. We'll see what happens there. They could make a deal at the deadline. We'll see what happens when Chris Sale comes back. You just had Tommy John surgery. You can't expect a ton out of him when he comes back in possibly July. So you know, it's a lot to ask for from him, but we'll see what happens. You know, so far they've been great, and it's been a lot of fun to watch. And like you said, and like I talked about before, Verdugo is fun to watch, man. He works the count. He's a ball player. He's very skilled. He's a very good athlete, but he's a ball player too, which is what we love up here in Boston.